Hey guys, welcome to Rotor Riot. I'm Bubby FUV, and this is going to be Spotlight. Oh yeah, that's Alex. Hey guys, welcome to Rotor Riot. I'm Bubby FUV,
and I'm Alex Vanover,
and this is Community Spotlight, where we show your videos because we think they're awesome.
Yeah, we have some really cool categories and some awesome videos from our community that we're gonna look through today, and you guys are gonna want to stay tuned because there's some really, really good stuff in this episode, and I think we should just jump right into it.
Yep, let's start with good old freestyle. First up, we have Lean Vander.
I saw this video, I'm like, oh, he's using the Vanny style, the old Vanny style frame and whatnot, and I'm always one for trees, and this is one of the best tree spots that there is.
Yep.
I love the little details in freestyle videos that there are. For example, when he takes off, you see him just for a moment there. I just think that's really cool because, like, he's the pilot. Yep. He's showing himself a little bit in the video.
Gets you in the mood to watch the epic video.
It makes me feel like I don't do enough in my videos, honestly. Yeah. I feel like if I did a little bit of B-roll and stuff, it would maybe take my videos up a little bit. But, I mean, this is just great flying. I mean, one thing I always like in freestyle videos is good flow and chaining lines together and not repeating the same move over and over. And he's doing a really good job with the cuts.
Yep.
But also with trying different stuff throughout the entire video. So this is just an excellent video, Lian. I'm really, really impressed by your freestyle. If you guys haven't seen Lian's videos, he has some more awesome freestyle videos on his channel.
He's also a really fast racer.
Yeah, he's a really, really good racing pilot.
Next up, we have Sync FPV with Epic Bando Adventure.
This is a really fun video too, because again, you have that...
Oh, that transition B-roll is nice.
Yeah, you have this awesome B-roll transition stuff. Sync is, and he is not afraid to push when he's flying as well. Let's go ahead and just cut straight to the flying.
He's done some crazy stuff. I think he's been in a couple of community spotlights before, and every time he just really amazes me.
One thing I really like in this too is the song choice is really good. It's kind of energizing, fits with the video, and he also shows the stick cam.
I love stick cam because I can really see what their movements are with their sticks and stuff.
And he's just not afraid to push through here. I don't really like flying around metal and bandos. I like flying around trees. He's just not afraid to push at all.
I wonder how much stuff he broke here, because like he's going full send into some of those gaps.
He does a really good job too with chaining lines together and surprising you with like what you think he's gonna do versus what he actually does.
Yeah.
I don't think a lot of current freestyle pilots do that. It's something that I'm trying to do myself, where you like you make it look like you're going to do one thing, and then you do another thing.
Yeah.
Really, really awesome stuff, Sync. I really can't wait to see what other videos you have coming out soon.
Next up in good old freestyle, we have PDevX. And I kind of recently, like last week, learned how to pronounce his name. It's PDevX. He's like the king of like those Maddie type of like mind-blowing stuff.
Can I just say, he's really the only person I think there is who's just trying all of these weird tricks, these reverse tricks, these Maddie flips, but trying to chain them together in very smooth lines. This is the video I actually picked out, and I picked this one out because I am a golden hour person. I love the lighting. I also appreciate how he's not using any additional stabilization. There's no GoPro stabilization, like hyper smooth. There's no real steady. Look at that.
That's
just reverse under the tree. I mean,
he's really pushing the limits of what we can do with our FPV jumps.
He's smooth too. He's so smooth when he's doing this too.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
He's one of my favorite pilots, if not my favorite pilot for sure. Just like, every time I watch
look
him,
at this,
like,
just how he winds around to the other side of the building. Like, these are the types of tricks that, right now, he's starting to pull them off, like, in lines as well, you know, like, flowing together. When he can do this in, like, a one take...
Oh, that'll be such a sick video.
I think a lot of people would agree. He's probably...
Oh my gosh! I saw that. I was like, what? I need to rewind that.
He's one of the few freestyle pilots as well that I can watch the entire video through and then hit rewind.
Yep. Dude, look at that. He did like a power loop
into
backwards dive.
He's really good flow too. I just want to point that out. Like, his flow is really good. I like how he's keeping it close to the trees.
Yep.
He's really smooth in his rolls. I mean, I don't know if he's on 4-cell. It looked like he was a little lacking on power there.
PDevX, are you on 4 or 6-cell?
We might need to get him some Vanover V2 motors.
Yeah. Speaking of Vanover V2s, the winner of this community spotlight, we will choose one of you. You get a set of Vanover V2 motors.
Yeah, my new motors just came out, Bubby. They are 2207 2021 KV. You've actually gotten to fly them a little bit recently.
I absolutely love them.
And they're really great motors. They're a bit stronger, a bit lighter, and a bit more powerful. Go ahead and check those out. Link in the description down below. Okay, so our next category.
Wait, steal it again.
So our next category is cinematic FPV. I feel like because the way FPV seems to be moving into this like new category of cinematic videos, I feel like it's worth showing a few videos from people who are doing cinematic stuff. And these guys aren't necessarily the most well-known guys as well. These are people I just found on YouTube, some of them with like no subscribers.
Yeah.
But we're going to watch the video, and I think you're going to be shocked by this first one. This is Shamkol FPV, 35 years from Chernobyl.
This is the first time I've seen some of these videos.
Dude, just watch this edit. It's a minute, 35 seconds. Just watch this edit, though. This edit is amazing. His fly is really, really good too.
Yeah.
The editing is incredible in this video.
And the music with like, it really sets the mood.
I'm assuming this is a GoPro. It looks way too good to be a GoPro though. I feel like this has to be a, like a Komodo or something. Cause I mean, I'm just looking at the fine detail. I don't think this is a GoPro. The more I thought the first time I watched this, that maybe some of these clips were worth a GoPro, but this clip right here is making me think maybe he's using something else.
That's the Chernobyl Duga Dive, right?
Yeah. What if I told you he has 231 subscribers?
Bruh, okay. Everyone needs to go subscribe to this guy, because that video is really incredible.
All shots I taked on DJI FPV drone. Sorry, haters.
What?
What?
You said the DJI FPV drone looks like a red Komodo.
Oh, no. Oh, no. This is my official, guys, it's been just an honor to be on Road to Riot episodes. Let's go and watch the next one, Mitchell Mullins. This is a video that you came across. This is not just your normal cinematic video.
This is like a full edit.
This is a full, like, short film. Look at these. Look at this.
They're in sand.
They're just, like, watching. This is cool.
The shots he's getting.
Yeah, look at that transition. I feel like all these people who are getting into FPV from the filming industry have all these tools when it comes to, like, editing and being really creative with their shots that you don't see a lot of, FPV freestyle pilots who make that transition have.
Yeah.
And it just opens my mind up to all the possibilities of FPV, because that's what these guys are doing. I mean, this flying is amazing. There's no disrespect, but like, you'll see a lot of flying where it's like, oh, the flying is okay.
Yeah.
But like, the editing is what makes the video so much better.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what this was shot on. It looks really, really good though. That's all I'm gonna say. Yeah. It looks really good.
It looks really good.
This is sick.
That's a helicopter.
That's like an F1 or F2.
Yeah.
Dang! Awesome video from these guys. 12.1K subscribers on YouTube. I think they deserve more than that.
Yeah.
Finally, in the cinematic category, we have Ross Has a Drone. Ross is actually a pretty well-known filming guy. He's not super well-known on YouTube necessarily, but if you go see his Instagram, he's pretty popular. And I wanted to pick this video out because he's not using stabilization, but this is a bit of a different look. He's using a GoPro, and he's chasing a skateboarder, and this raw look just really fits. I don't know.
That's no stabilization?
No, there's no stabilization.
He's really smooth.
This is with a CineWhoop. So, wow. Like, you know how a CineWhoop flies as well.
Yeah.
I mean, shout out to Ross. I mean, his stuff is always really fun to watch on Instagram, but I was really, really impressed with this flight because, I mean, it's just cool, you know?
I like the kind of no stabilization look on this because I can feel like I'm right there.
You feel like you're a skateboarder. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But it's still very smooth. It's just sweet. Well, that was our cinematic category. Be sure to go check out Ross Has a Drone. Now, we have a category that you kind of pioneered a little bit.
We have the Young Rippers category. And every single person in this category came from my Young Rippers Discord server. Mm-hmm. So we have a Discord server. If you are 13 to 20 and you would like to join, go ahead and DM me on Instagram at BubbyFPV and I'll get you a link. So first up, we have DigiFPV with some flowy forest freestyle. And he has kind of a more of a spangy, juicy type of flying. And this is no stabilization.
This is no stabilization.
No stabilization at all.
Dang, how old is he?
I think he's like 16 or 17. I know these spang pilots don't like to use stabilization because it has that, like, hyper smooth.
It takes away the look of...
Yeah, that they want.
Yeah, I'm going to follow this guy for sure. DigiFPV.
DigiFPV. Only 920 subscribers.
Get that number up. Good song choice, a good classic FPV song. Really awesome freestyle video. And I'm more impressed by the fact that he wasn't using stabilization because that was all in his fingers and in his time spent tuning that quad. So
yeah.
Really, really awesome stuff. I would love to see what he could do with something a little bit more open. Maybe it doesn't fit his spang style a little bit, but that's only a compliment to you, man. Awesome. That's a hard location to do that kind of flying in because there's so much stuff to hit and whatnot. So shout out to you, man.
JWebFPV.
Mm-hmm.
One of my favorite pilots right now. There's the spangy stuff, but this video is more of like a montage.
What is spang?
I've been trying to discover what spang means, and spang is an onomatopoeia, so when his quad goes, it's spang, spang. That's what it is. It's the sound the quad makes.
So this is S-Bang, FPV freestyle.
Spang.
Spang, I know, spang.
Yeah.
Really, really juicy, good flow.
There's like a bunch of different spots in here, which is nice.
Yeah, this is spang, where basically you're doing a lot of open air tricks is what it seems like.
J-Web, awesome job. We love that video so much.
It was a really
good video. FPV Hawk up next. We're going to be watching him.
He's pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, he's really good.
Yeah, I was actually wanting to use him, and you were like, already had him.
Yeah, I already had him. He's my Young Ripper.
And he posts a lot of videos, too, which I appreciate, because they're all amazing. Look at that.
It's crazy.
Man, really good flow, too. What I really like is how this guy, he'll like do a split S, and then when you think he's just going to go under the tree, he rolls it into like a Matty flip or something.
He's really good at those Matty flips.
Yeah, he does a really, really good job. I really like the scenery he's flying around. I mean, look at this. He's got mountains in the background.
Really pretty. Oh, that was cool.
Oh, man. I love watching these types of videos, man. It's just, the flow is amazing. I mean, all the guys on Community Spotlight have just been killing it recently. Yeah. And I'm becoming fans of all you guys very, very quickly, and especially these young rippers, because, you know, they're so young too. By the time they're our age, just think of how good they're gonna be.
Yeah.
You know, they have more time to get better. I mean, you too, Bubby. I mean,
you're only 21 too. You could have been a young ripper about a couple months ago.
I mean, I was a young ripper back in my day.
Back in my day. This kid, I've seen him mostly on Instagram.
I like the song.
He's known as Pablo Flor on Instagram, and he is,
I know this kid,
really good.
He's a racing pilot too, so like,
oh, he is. Okay.
This is where you'll see a lot of this technical skill come in. He's not using stabilization.
He's not. I'm pretty sure he's using a Hero 4 session.
And you can see that those technical skills he's learned from racing really translate to his freestyle, but he's really, really smooth, and that's something you don't see from a lot of racing pilots that go to freestyle. So he's got the best of both worlds.
That was a cool dive. Nice,
I like how he puts his DVR in too. I like that element.
Yeah.
Ooh, that was nice. He was gonna hit that wall.
I'm pretty sure this is a one take.
This is, I think so.
There's been no cuts so far.
So I'm really, really excited about this next category, because this is one that I wanted to be put in here, and this is non-stabilization freestyle. I am so, so impressed with the guys who go out there, and especially these pilots we're gonna showcase, who can fly freestyle, and you're not gonna see any little twitches or little movements like that. And this is without stabilization. So let's go to look at the first one. This is from a racing pilot, actually.
Ooh, I know him.
Propsicle FPV. He's a young ripper, I suppose. And he mostly does racing stuff. He's one of the fastest pilots in the nation right now. And I was just going through his YouTube channel the other day, you know, looking at his racing content. And I saw Spring Flow come up. And I was like, oh, okay. No stabilization.
This is no stabilization. That's really smooth.
Yeah, he's a really, really smooth pilot. And Propsicle has always been a really good pilot, and a really good freestyle pilot. But this video I saw, and I was like, man, the cuts. And this is some spang right here.
Yeah.
And he's doing it in the trees, and he's so smooth. He's really, you can see that he's been flying a lot. I'm not just talking freestyle or racing, but he's just been flying both so much. And guys, if you want to get better at any type of flying that you're doing, whether it's cinematic flying, freestyle, or racing, the best piece of advice I can give to you is to just go out and fly a lot. This kid's been out there racing a lot, and his freestyle has gotten better as a result of all that stick time. But yeah, really, really awesome stuff, Propsicle. If you guys aren't following him or subscribed to him, be sure to do so, because he is not only a freestyle pilot, but he's also one of the best racing pilots. And I know there's gonna be a whole nother category later in this video about racing, but just to give you an idea of how much he's improved, we're just gonna quickly play, and it's called Pressure. I just want you to watch this video. I feel like it's worth showcasing this from him.
I don't understand racers. Everything's just whizzing past so fast that I can't even, like, I don't know how my brain's struggling thinking about it.
What makes him such a smooth freestyle pilot is look at how smooth he is when he's racing. You don't see the suit. I mean, he's aggressive, right? But he's not, like, out of control like some of the other pilots appear to be. He's very, very smooth, but he's taken really aggressive lines. If you're a racing pilot, freestyle will help you become a better racing pilot. And I also believe if you're a freestyle pilot, that racing, going through these gates at these high speeds, it'll just make you even more confident hitting gaps. I highly recommend you guys don't limit yourself to one aspect of the hobby. I wanted just to show a little bit of this because this pilot is one of the best pilots in the world, I believe, right now. And
yeah,
he's still so young. So be sure to go
14,
follow.
Right?
I think so, 14 or 15.
That's crazy.
Be sure to go follow Propsicle on social media and be sure to subscribe to him. Our next guy is Balkanex FPV. And I believe this was your pick, right?
Yeah, so Balkanex is a local ripper to me. He lives in Southern California, and I rip with him pretty often. And he has really amazing flow. Every time I fly with him or watch his videos, I'm really impressed.
And this is another non-stabilized clip, I can tell already.
Yep.
And one way I can tell if a clip is using like hypersmooth stabilization or not is I can tell because hypersmooth usually crops the super view in just a little bit to help stabilize it.
Yeah.
So when it looks very fisheye, I can generally tell it's not stabilized. And I really like his smooth, flowy transitions between elements. I could watch this type of flying all day long. It's just very relaxed to me. Another great song choice. I mean, shout out to all the people again in this Community Spotlight, because you guys are out there just killing it, and you've given us some really awesome videos to watch.
Yeah. Awesome video, Balkanex. Keep it up, man.
All right, the final non-stabilized video we have is from our buddy George FPV. We featured him a few times before, but this is one of his latest videos. He's kind of took a little bit of a break maybe from posting videos, it seemed like, but this is one of the videos he posted recently, and you would think that this is stabilized by how smooth it is. And he's just an amazing pilot.
when you mix like a really good flying quad and like a butter pilot, this is what you get. Like really smooth, no jerks in his flying at all.
And the two kind of go hand in hand together. I think part of flying is being able to tune your quad really well. Because I mean, ultimately a lot of these maneuvers, like these big split S's and everything, you can't do them that cleanly if your quad isn't tuned a little bit. But this is just a really flowy, awesome video, but very juicy style of flying, where he does these reverse transitions and these big rolls over trees. I try and fly this type of style, so I know how much time it takes to go out there and have a quad that's well tuned and have a good flow video like this. So shout out to George FPV for putting that time in, and man, I just love watching your stuff. Final category.
Racing
category. Anytime I'm here, we're gonna have a racing category, and these guys in particular, there's some really fast pilots, but you may not know who they are. We're gonna start off with, in my opinion, one of the fastest guys in the US right now, in the world for that matter, Noickel.
I know Noickel.
You know Noickel? This is in his backyard. This video, all these videos are gonna hurt your brain.
Yeah.
But he has progressed so much in the last 2 years. I like how he puts some effort into his racing videos as well. You don't usually see that. You just, like on my videos too, I just slap music to DVR. Like now he's going wide up. Look at his battery voltage.
Oh,
he's
wow.
Literally just full throttling. And he's like, yeah, I get like 30, 40 seconds of flight time on a 1400 6S.
That's crazy, man. My brain just hurts watching these videos, and everything just whizzes past me.
And he's just, I kind of miss the days of being really young and being able just to train a lot.
Up next, we have Hyper FPV, and I don't know who he is, but he's fast.
I remember going to 2019 National Championships, and he didn't have a quad to fly, or something happened. So he flew one of my quads and like caught on fire midair or something.
Oh my
like
gosh.
That. Yeah, I felt so bad. But I always knew he was a really good pilot, but I never kind of considered him as, you know, one of the fast guys, right? But then he started surprising a lot of pilots last year in 2020. He started practicing, he started getting better gear, and all of a sudden he hit this whole nother level. And I like his flying style a lot because he's so smooth. It reminds me a lot of my style, but taken up a notch. He also does 60 frames per second DVR. He's a guy you should be keeping an eye out for because, I mean, all these racing pilots we're gonna showcase, these are the future of FPV racing, I feel like.
So all of these guys are pretty young then?
Most of these guys are pretty young. I think Mason is a year older than me. So he's 22, so he's representing us old dogs, which sounds really funny because like 21, 22 years old.
Yeah.
But like most of the fast racing pilots are like 18 or younger. So next guy, Leviathan FPV. This is a guy that I don't think I've actually gotten to meet in person yet. And he's been podiuming a lot of big races in the United States recently. And so again, look at the battery voltage. It's just
that like
the battery is just crying.
Is it on takeoff 20 volts for the 6S?
I mean, he's just full throttling. Look at this.
Wow.
And then, okay, I want to give him some extra respect too, because this is a pretty wide open track, and wide open tracks I find are much harder to fly on a fast 5-inch quad because you have to be much more mature on the controls. Like you have to balance your throttle a lot more. You have to know when to slow down, when to air brake. I mean, he's just not letting off. I mean,
yeah.
Oh my goodness, like he's counting it so close. And when you're going this fast too, if you hit anything, I don't care if it's a flag or if it's a gate, the battery's just done.
The battery's just done.
I mean, if you hit anything going that fast, it's gonna be total carnage. All right, our final one is a true young ripper, Jake Hammer FPV. I wanted to showcase his tiny trainer video. So he's flying like a little tiny racing quad, and he flies 5-inch quads. He's another one of the fastest guys that's out there right
How
now.
How old is he?
He's gotta be under 14 or 15.
Really? Though. Wow.
He's so young. This is a pretty simple track that he set up at his house, but I've been watching him for a few months now, and every time I watch one of his videos, I see a whole nother level of improvement to his flying. He's getting much smoother. He's also getting much more confident on the controls. I see that, and he's not making so many little corrections as he approaches gates. He's just, I got the gate lined up. But these are some racing pilots that you guys should definitely check out and subscribe to. And these are just a few too. Like, I mean, I could have made this racing
the whole
segment,
episode,
the whole
racing.
Episode, yeah. For sure. And hopefully too, we'll have some more racing content coming out on the Rotorite channel.
Yeah. So Alex, who was your favorite pick to win your Vanover B2 Motors?
Man, there's so many good pilots. This, honestly, I've done one community spotlight before, I think. And every time I see or do a community spotlight, I just feel like the talent pool has gone up another level. I just want to say I'm really honored to be a part of this community because all these videos, just getting to watch them and getting to know a lot of these pilots personally too, it's just so awesome to see FPV being pushed so much farther into the future from where the technology even is right now. So really, really exciting. I don't know. It's so hard to pick. I'm just going to have to go with my gut here. And I think I know the video. It's this guy right here.
Digi FPV. Congratulations, man. You did awesome, and you have a set of Vanover V2 motors coming your way.
This is, I think, out of all the videos I watched, I'm just very, very impressed with this flying. There's not a moment in this video that I'm bored.
Yeah.
There's just every moment I'm just like stuck watching the camera. I'm so impressed, and I think I also noticed in his description as well that he was flying some 6L stuff already, so I'm really, really excited for you to try the Vanover V2 motors, and we'll see how you like those for freestyle.
Yeah. Thanks, guys, so much for watching this episode of Community Spotlight.
Be sure to subscribe, hit that bell so you know when we post videos. We post every single Monday. Be sure to check out our store in the link in the description as well. That's how you support us directly, by buying stuff. I'm Alex Vanover.
I'm Bobby FPV.
And we'll see you on the next one. Peace!
No, we're not doing this again.
No, I can do it.
Turn the cameras off.